Myanmar coup, the people shot dead since the protests began. More than 700 people have been killed by security forces since Myanmar's military grabbed power in a coup on 1 February, according to the Assistance Association for Political Prisoners, Burma. The spoken to loved ones of three people who have died. As Myanmar's coup violence continues to spiral, so has the number of its victims as a crackdown on protesters intensifies. Some of those who died had taken part in anti-coup protests, while others, including children, were simply sitting in their homes when they were killed. Here, three families share their stories. 14-year-old Bani Fayu was an ardent supporter of the pro-democracy movement, and had made several TikTok videos of herself singing pro-democracy songs. Fearing for her safety, her mother Theta San didn't let her join the street protests. But that wasn't enough to save her. Bani Fayu was shot inside her house as she wanted to open the door to protesters fleeing a military crackdown on 27 March. It was also the deadliest day since the coup began. At least 114 people, including 11 children, were killed. She suddenly fell down and I thought she had slipped. But then I saw the blood on her back and realized she had been shot, Theta San told, breaking into tears. In Burmese, Pan means flower, I means soft, and Fayu means white. My daughter was a beautiful girl when she was born, just like a soft little flower. That's why I gave her the name. She recounted how helpful her daughter was around the house, and how she dreamed about opening an orphanage when she got older. I feel like my life is not worth living without my child. I want to die instead of her. Bani Fayu's death has also deeply affected her younger brother, 10-year-old MG Sai Sai. He did not sleep at all on the night his sister died, and kept watching her TikTok videos instead, Theta San said. The family have since moved house because Theta San is worried something bad will happen to them again. Our lives are not safe anymore,